We are looking at chapter number 10, practical geometry. So we have seen number of shapes. We know how to make a line segment. We know how to make a perpendicular to this line segment, how to make an angle, and how to make the angle bisector. So we'll start with the construction of a line parallel to a given line through a point not on the line. So how to draw a line which is parallel to this line with a point which is not on this line, which is not on this line. So let us start with an activity, then you will understand better. Let's take a paper, make a fold, and this fold, give it a name L. So this is a L, this is a line, and take any point A here. Then again fold this paper like this, which is passing through A, so that a line becomes this. So this will be a perpendicular bisector. Now again take this A and fold this paper again in this direction, like this direction, okay. So when you fold it, there will be a line again. So this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree. And we know that for two lines to be parallel, the corresponding angle has to be equal. That is why these two lines are equal. So you can use the ruler or compass, you can use the properties of transversal and parallel lines to make the construction. Again, using only the ruler and compasses. So, if you want to make a line, again, let us take a ruler and compass. First of all, make a line L, take a point A. Now, just join this A and B. When you join this A and B, make this, or you can say any convenient radius you can take, and draw an arc which is cutting L at C. L at C like this. Okay. Again, take that same address, this radius, and placing it here, make again an arc. Okay. Now, just your pencil here or and your point here. Just stretch till you get DC. What I'm saying is, place the pointed tip of the compass at C. And the adjust the opening such that the pencil tip is at C. With this, actually you have got an angle now. Now just place again with this same opening, place it here and cut here, say at H. Now join AH. This line will be parallel to this line. How? Because this angle is this angle you have measured by this construction. This angle and this angle is equal. So, when two lines, the interior opposite angle are equal by the property of parallel lines and transversal, these two angles become equal and these two lines becomes parallel. So, this is how we make the parallel lines. These are two way you can make. Constructions of angle with three angles, say triangle. So, triangle means there are certain things for a triangle. First of all, it has three vertices, then three sides, and then three angles. So we'll use the property of this angle and side to construct. First of all, let us recall the properties we know about triangle. First of all, the exterior angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angle. First is this. The total measure of the angles of a triangle is 180 degree, and the sum of length of any two side you take, and if you add it, it has to be greater than the third side. And for any right angle triangle like this, this is 90 degree, the sum of squares of the arms, that is B square plus A square, will be equal to the sum of the other side which is opposite to this 90 degree, that is C square. So, in congruence of triangle also, when we made congruency, we say when two triangles are congruent, there are certain things or say criterias were there. First of all, three sides, two sides and angle between them, two sides, two angles and side between them, and the RHS, that is the hypotenuse, and a leg in the case of a right angle triangle. So with these things in our mind, we can construct triangles. We are not making congruence things, but we are just making triangle using this scenario. First of all, we have to construct a triangle with three sides given. For example, if you have to construct a triangle ABC, AB is 5, BC is 6 and AC is 7. So, three sides are given, and please mark that you have to make a rough sketch. If you make a rough sketch, it will be very easier to make the triangle. First of all, what we are going to do? We are going to make this line BC. So this line we are going to make, say 6. You can measure it and make it. Then take, place your point here, and with distance as 5. From here, distance 5, just cut an arc. Again, take distance as 7 and cut an arc. The point of intersection you just joined. This is your required triangle. So first you have to make this 6, right? Then with taking radius as 5 and using your compass, cut an arc 5. Then again, place your point at C, cut an arc with length 7. And this is the required triangle. So this is your required triangle by 3 sides. If 3 sides are given, you can make triangle like this. So we have certain things. Let me tell you, okay, let's discuss and write something. See, somebody is trying to make a triangle with length 6, 2 and 3. So what he has done, he has made a line of 6. Now when he is trying to cut an arc 3 and 2, these 3 and 2, they are not intersecting anywhere. Why? Just remember the property of the triangle, that sum of two sides of a triangle is always greater than the third side. That is, if you add 3 and 2, this will be less than 6, and this is not possible. So the triangle is not possible. Then we use the SAS criterion to make a triangle. In this we have side, two sides and an angle. But this angle is in between those sides. This side and this angle. And just make a rough sketch. So what we are going to do here is, we'll make a line of 5.5. We'll take a radius 3 from here, cut here, and we'll make an angle of 60 degree. You know, I'm sure you'll be knowing how to make angles. So 60 degree, just extend it. Or you can say, the other thing is, you can make 5.5, make an angle 60 degree, and then place a point here, and with taking radius as 3, cut it here and join. This is your required triangle. So first you make a line, then you make an angle, and then you cut 3 and join these two. When you join these two, there will be a triangle. This is how you obtain the triangle. So we'll take one more thing, that if AB equal to 3, AC equal to 5, and angle equal to 30, can we draw the triangle? Let us see. This is triangle angle C, this is 30 degree. We can make 30 degree easily, and AC is 5, okay? Make it A. AC is 5. We can make 5 and then make a 30 degree. Now AB is 3. AB is 3. Now the problem is that this side is not included. This side is not included. What we can do here is, we can place our, because this is 5 and this is 30 degree. See, AC is 5 and C is 30 and AB is given. This line is given. So what we can do here is, we can place a point, cut 3 here. We can do that. You know, we can make 3 and this side can be anything. But for the properties intervention, we understand that the enough information is not given. So we just say that not sufficient information is given for construction. Then we make a triangle with ASA criterion. Means we have two angles and a side which is included. So if you have to make this triangle, what you have to do is, make XY equal to 6, 6. Make a 60 degree angle here. Make a 100 degree angle and allow them to intersect. This is your required triangle. So you make 6. Then you make a 30 degree angle. Then you make a 100 degree angle. And allow them to stretch so that they intersect at some point. And this is your required triangle. Then if we have AC, angle A and angle B is given. Can you draw the triangle? Let us see whether we can be able to make it or not. This is A, this is B. This A is 60 degree. This B is 50 degree. Say 50 degree. Now this is given to be 7. Can we draw? Because A and B is given and AC is given. Sorry. This C is given, not B. So this is not 7. We can cut a mark 7 here and we can join. We can join here. But the problem is that we don't know this angle and we only know this side, one side. So what we can do here is, we can use the angle sum property. 60 plus 50 is 110. subtract it from 180, you get 70. So now we'll change this scenario. We'll make A here 60 degree. We'll make this second angle 70 degree, which is our C. Okay, C 70 degree. And wherever it is intersecting, actually that will be our triangle. There is no problem, because this 70 degree and 60 degree, because AC is given, we can make 7 and we just allow to intersect, because this will anyhow be 50 degree. Then we have RHS criterion. We have the RHS, it is quite easy to make, because we have a triangle here, LN is 5, MN is 3. So we are making MN like this is 3, make a 90 degree angle and just put a point here, cut 5 and you join it. This is the triangle. So this is how we make a triangle, make 3, make a perpendicular and cut 5. So this will be your final triangle. This is how you draw the triangle using these ruler and compass. So there are certain questions which are there. Let us take few of them. For example, if this is given, Q is given 30, R is given 60. We have to make QR equal to 4.7. So make QR 4.7. Then Q as 30 degree and R as 60 degree. So where they intersect, this is your required triangle. How about any three sides like this? 3, 4 and 5. First you have to add them, you know. 3 plus 4 is greater than 5, 5 plus 4 is greater than 3 and 3 plus 5 is greater than this one. So now you will be able to make the triangle. First of all, take 5, take radius 3, cut it here, take radius 4, cut it here. This is your required triangle. This is. So what we have discussed in chapter, we can draw parallel lines by various properties. We can make the corresponding angle equal, we can make the interior opposite angle equal, we can make the triangle using SAS, SSS, ASA and RHS. So thank you so much. This is about the practical geometry.